in your life.
Lift up your voice and thank the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you. This is the day thou hast made. Father, we will be glad and rejoice in it. We thank you, we bless your holy name. Lord, we say, great are you, Lord. Father, we thank you for the life of the members of this house, the life of our Papa, his family, your doings in this house of God. We have come to render praise and thanksgiving unto you. Lord, we bow before you. 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 In the mighty name of Jesus, we are praying and worship. Let us shout the greatest and the biggest amen in this place.
My heart and with my soul.
be that you were unable to help me. But now, oh Lord, I see my wrong. Heal my heart and show yourself strong.
Thank you. This is not something you find in the Bible. This is my revelation. We've walked with you. And we are all Hebrews. We have been praying. Praying. Just like you do. But we have realized that every time that you pray, the heavens respond. We have realized that every time that you fast, something happens. We have realized that by the mere opening of your mouth, the heavens respond to your tone. So today we want to know, why is it that we are praying the same prayer? How many times have you come to a point where you ask yourself that I have been praying? As a pastor, I find so many people come to me and they tell me, man of God, I fast, I pray, I pay my tithes, I go to church. Whatever that is required of me as a Christian, I do. And I've been praying about a problem, that, but there is no solution. My finances have been crippled, but I find no solution. My marriage is going down, and the more I pray, the more somebody is breaking it up. Why? So you could see the reason why they went to Jesus is that, you know, when people get results in the church, when men of God get results in the church, when church members get results in the church, sometimes you find the haters, what they will say is that no, they have left the church and they have gone and they have found something else. When a man of God begins to exhibit the power of God through prophecy, through healing, through deliverance, because these are free gifts, because some pastors cannot open their mouth to pray for God to drop these gifts in them, they will criticize, this is not of God. God does not work in that way. That's not how God does his stuff. Because they are not finding results. But they know that they are praying. So as far as they are praying, this simply means that if somebody is getting results in prayer, that means that the person is doing something else. But these people, the thing is, somebody like Peter, and I'm pretty sure that if Peter was the one that asked the question, somebody like Peter was somebody that when Jesus sleeps, he's by him. When Jesus is walking, he's walking with him. Before Jesus would take a shower, he's taking a shower with him. Whatever Jesus does, his eye sees it. So he has realized that Jesus himself has not any other power, but except that when he opens his mouth, something happens because the heavens respond. So they came to a point that no, we know that this man has not gone to for voodoo. He has not gone to take anything. But every time he opens his mouth, something happens. So there must be a secret.
Amen.
There must be a secret. So they went to Jesus.
You know, sometimes it's amazing, as a man of God, sometimes my papa will tell me, some pastors can call him and ask him, Kofi, we have been in ministry for a long time. We are tired. Please, whatever you know, tell us. He said, whatever I know, all I know is prayer.
Amen.
All I know is faith.
Amen.
All I know is that one time I was at a place and God called me.
Amen.
And when he called me, he said, hear to my voice and I will make you great.
Amen.
So all I've done is to do the will of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
So they went to him because they don't see where Jesus is going because they are with him 24/7. Or if he has something, sometimes they will see that he will do some incantations. But these guys are with him. You see, sometimes when you read certain scriptures in the Bible, you don't actually picture the scenario. They were not getting the same results. And Jesus said, the resource is in a simple prayer. You see, that our Father prayer in the Bible holds about 96 spiritual keys.
Amen.
And when decoded and deprogrammed, you will walk in the edge like a spirit.
Amen.
Because you are a spirit. Our Father, that we pray every day. So Jesus said, okay, I'm going to give you the key. So from now, this is how you pray. But you see, the prayer was done literally, but there was a spiritual base to the prayer. He said, you go, you say, our Father, who art in heaven. And he went on. And then he said, let your kingdom come. I remember there was a time I was preaching about just let your kingdom come. And he said, thy will be done on earth. As it is, not like. The word he used is not like. He said, as it is. That means that you can't change any character of how heaven is. The as it is in heaven, so shall it be here on earth for us.
Amen.
Amen.
So if heaven, demons cannot come there and torment the angels. When I pray that prayer, demons cannot torment my life.
Amen.
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 He said, as it is. The Bible says that one day when Satan said, he was bound from heaven.
Amen.
Bound from heaven. So that means that all the demons that are tormenting you here on earth, those demons cannot go into heaven.
Amen.
Are you getting the picture?
Yes.
So, if Jesus is saying to them, pray and say, let your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. Jesus is saying that heaven, there is no diabetes.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Amen.
Heaven, there is no blood pressure.
Amen.
Heaven, there is no barrenness in heaven.
Amen.
So if you are praying and telling the Lord to let your life be as it is in heaven, you are saying it, but you don't understand it. Heaven, there is no poverty. Because the Bible says that God is the one that created the heavens and created the earth, so all they that dwell in the earth and its inhabitants belong unto him. So God cannot be poor.
Yeah.
The gold in the earth belong to him. Diamond belong to him. Oil belong to him. All the treasures of the deep ocean belong to our great Lord. How is it possible that every day you are praying this prayer and you are going to the Lord, let it be in heaven as it is in earth, and you are still poor? The Bible says that ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free.
Amen.
So when Jesus lifted up his head unto heaven and said, Father, let it be on earth as it is in heaven, he knows that immediately, if you are a demon, you cannot come near him.
Amen.
Poverty cannot come near him.
Amen.
Sickness cannot come near him.
Amen.
Because he's in heaven. And just as he says in heaven, that is the same way he's portraying here on earth.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Your will. So this simply means that the will of God for your life is spiritual. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
The will of God for your life is a spiritual thing. So that means that you cannot digest the will of God physically.
You understand? You are not getting me.
Preach.
Otherwise, somebody will be clapped.
Because if you were getting the will of God to be spiritual, you are now understand why the Bible says that without faith, it is impossible to please God.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because faith is a spiritual thing.
Yes.
And the only way that one can go to God in heaven is to believe the things that you do not see. Spiritual things cannot be seen. But if you know that there's a spirit in me, and I understand that I have what the physical world is telling me that I don't have, that means that now I'm moving by faith, and as a result, that will of God, which is spiritual, is being activated.
Yeah.
Today I pray for somebody that may God give you a revelation.
Yeah.
That when you look, and you look unto the earth, you look unto the sky, you will see where your help coming from. And that help is not coming from the physical person, but that help is coming from
the Lord.
Now watch this.
So the will of God, by my understanding, can only be activated in your life by faith.
Amen.
Amen.
So, mommy, every time we pray, let it be here on earth as it is in heaven. Because we don't have faith, they are mere words.
Mm-hmm.
But when Jesus prays that prayer, the moment angels surround him.
Amen.
Because the Bible says that in heaven, there are legions of angels
yes.
that surround the throne of God.
Mm-hmm.
And day and night, they cry, holy, holy, holy. You see, David had gone from one point to another point. You see, David, you might look at David as a sinner, but David was living in a spiritual.
Amen.
That,
David was in a realm of his own. That is why David was able to discern in the book of Psalm 91. He said that, God, it is you that have given charge of your angels to encamp around me.
Amen.
And that is your will. So this means that every time I'm going out, angels are around me.
Yes.
Because it's like heaven on earth.
Yes.
Richard.
The will of God.
Amen.
So let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, when we talk about wills, there are three major different kinds of will The first one is the will of God. If you have a pen, you can be writing. The first one is the will of what? And the second one, who can guess it? It's the will of Satan. You know where I'm going. And the third one, who can guess it? The will of man. And this is not an assumption. This is not something we can assume that that is what it is. The Bible tells us that these three wills exist. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
Man of God, open your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 26, the verse 39. Who is there? And the Bible talks about Jesus when Jesus was in Golgotha. And the Bible says that Jesus had come to a point where all that was going to happen to him had been revealed to him. And when you read the earlier verses, it says that his heart was grieving. So on the 39, he prayed a prayer. What did he say?
And he went a little further.
Went a little further.
And fell on his face.
And fell on his face.
And prayed.
And prayed.
Saying.
Saying.
Oh my Father.
Oh my Father.
If it be.
If it be possible.
Possible. Let this cup pass from me.
Let this cup pass from me.
Yes.
Go on.
Nevertheless.
But nevertheless, that means that that is my will. And now, as a human being, because Jesus was now in a human form. As a human being, I'm looking at this suffering and I'm telling you that, Lord, let this cup pass by me. But I know that it is not my will that I need to pray to be, but it has to be your will. Because the will of God has a purpose. The will of God has a fulfillment. The will of God brings victory.
Amen.
So even though I am human now, as Christ, but Lord, I'm looking at this suffering that is coming, and this suffering is too much for me to bear. So if it be, my human flesh is saying that, if it be, let it pass me by. But don't let this will, because this is not coming from the spirit, this is coming from the body that is going to be tormented. But let your will be done.
Amen.
Nevertheless, not as I will.
Not as I will.
But as thy will.
But as thy will.
Amen.
So this simply suggests that there is a will of man. Man has a will. You know why man has a will? The will of man is driven by flesh and lust. When somebody pinch you, it hurts, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, I remember in Ghana, they used to tell a story that one time there was this church, they were having service. And back in those days, Ghana churches, the radical, when you build your house close to a church, that means that there's no sleep in the house. Because they worship 7 days a week, every hour, and you don't know where they get their drums. When they start hitting it, and one of these churches, they were hitting the thing. And they have a song that they used to sing. They say, Metia Brum Samso. That simply means, I have stepped on the devil. Metia Brum Samso. And they'll be hitting the drum. And people are dancing and they are really stepping on the devil. Metia Brum Samso. And there was this cripple who was also sitting by. So, there was somebody that's house was very close to the people. And these people have been disturbing him. So one time they were doing an all night. And this guy dressed in all black and he put a ninja thing on his face. And he put some tin horn on his head. And as they were doing and the pastor was dancing, everybody was dancing. The moment this guy entered the thing, the first person out was the pastor. The pastor is gone. What about the elders? Everybody. And these people, when they were running, he couldn't run some. So he was still sitting there. And the man went and looked at him and said, "So you two, you are mom. That they accept from me." He said, "Devil, you look at my condition." The song says, "We are setting you alone. But you look at me, my condition. I'm sitting down. How is it that I can be participating in those that are stepping on you?" The will of God. So the will, man has a will. Man has a will. And every time the will of man is exercised, it is based on flesh and lust. So if they were really believing in the word that they have believed, then they shall trample upon the devil. If the devil appeared, why are you running? Because they know that if the devil touches them, something is going to happen to your body. So they run. The flesh of man goes through pain. When your belly, you feel hungry. You are very hungry. There was a time that somebody came to me and said that he doesn't know how he's going to pay the bill. He doesn't even know where his next meal is going to come from. And he doesn't, there's so much going on in their lives and they have lost their jobs. And as soon as I was sitting there, and I said, let's pray. He looked in my eye and said, "Pastor, this is not the prayer time. It is real, real. This one is real, real. If you can give me $100 or even 50, I'll settle for 20. So that I can be assured that I can buy something for me to eat and feed my children. Man is driven by flesh and lust, sight. So your will, you know, Papa always talks about a story where his friends, they were praying. They prayed, everybody was praying for God, somebody was praying for a mobile phone. Look at this in Africa. The prayer topic, mobile phone. Somebody was praying that he'll get money to rent a place. One of them was praying that he will find a wife. And another was praying whatever prayer. But Papa, a car. And Papa said, "Lord, I need anointing."
Amen.
You see, the thing about anointing is that you cannot see.
Yeah.
But it activates physically.
Amen.
So they got what they wanted because God listened to their prayer. But they got to a point, they are physical, material things. They lost it. How many people have bought houses in America that they have lost? I see some stars. There's this program on TV, Stars. When they are there, they bought these Bentleys, Maybachs and whatever, and they go and they pick it up. Just take it away.
Yeah.
They are material things.
Very right.
And that is what the will of man is. Most of our prayer to God is that, "God, bless my children. God, please let my finances increase.
Lord, please, please, Father. I pray that there's this sister that is troubling my husband. Most our prayer are physical beings.
Yes.
Our physical what? Beings. And that is the will of man. It's driven by flesh. Earthly things. Okay? And when you read the book of John 10:10, the Bible says that the thief cometh not but to what?
To steal.
To destroy. And to kill.
Mm-hmm.
That is the will of the devil. Because right in the Garden of Eden, the devil came and the devil stole the glory that God had given to man. And that is the will of the devil. The devil wants to steal your job. The devil wants to touch your children, destroy their lives. And in the end, kill you prematurely without you having salvation. That is the will of the devil. So everything to do with the devil is geared towards destruction. And that is his will. Do you know why? Because the Bible says that they eat and drink with you, but their heart is not with you. As a man tempted, so is he. He, the devil, has been bound from heaven, so he's looking for companions that will join him in hell. So the devil knows that me, I cannot make it to heaven. So as many people I can take with me to hell, that is what I want. That is the will of the devil. To take you to hell. So he came to steal, kill you before your time. So that there is no repentance. There is no redemption. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
By the will of God. The perfect will of God for your life. Jesus said that I came so that ye may have life and have it more. But now let me finish by telling you one more thing. When you come to the will of God, there are two kinds of the will of God. There are two kinds of the will of God. There is the perfect will of God, and there is a permissive will of God. Somebody write it down. The perfect will of God, and what? The permissive will of God. Do you believe it?
Yes.
Someone will say the will of God is the will of God. Have you read a scripture that says that ask and it shall be given?
Yes.
Do you know the Bible is true? Knock and you shall be open. Do you know the Bible is true?
Yes.
And that is God. If you pray earnestly, he says, the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much.
Amen.
So there are times that you can pray with faith. And even though it is not in the will of God, it is in the permissive will of God, but not the perfect will. And God will permit you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Open your Bible to the book of 1 Kings. Chapter 3. And read from verse 8 quickly. Keep up right.
1 Kings chapter 3, verse 8.
Uh-huh.
And thy servant is in the midst of thy people,
uh-huh,
which thou hast chosen.
Which thou hast chosen. Uh-huh.
A great people. That cannot be numbered.
That cannot be numbered.
Nor counted.
For multitude.
Give therefore.
Thy servant.
An understanding heart.
This is Solomon praying to what? God. And what is this? Solomon was the beloved son of David. So let me tell you something. Solomon, the secret here is that Solomon was with his father most of the time. And after the death of Absalom, Solomon became the person that was very close to his dad. So Solomon saw the heart of his father for God and the keys. You know, the biblical archaeologists,
They believe that David had a special book from God. This is not Bible. This is something some group of people believe. And they believe that in that book, it contains some keys that releases faith to activate the heavens. And they believe that that book was passed on to his son Solomon. So Solomon, the Bible says that God looked at David. You see, there are many prophets and many great men in the Bible that walk with God. But none of them that God said that this is a man after my own heart. Do you know why? Because David had the key to the heart of God.
Amen.
And that was true faith.
Amen.
So when Solomon took over the throne, Solomon, as he was a young boy who was about to take over the nation of Israel, the Bible says that Solomon went and prayed his prayer to God. That, Lord, I'm a young boy. Look at the nation of Israel. It's made out of prophets. It's made out of great men. And these are your people. How can, is it possible that a small boy like me can control this nation? Read on.
Give therefore thy servant an understanding heart to judge thy people, that I may discern between good and bad.
So that means that if I can rule these people, you have to give me an elevated wisdom that will be above them all.
Hey.
Read on.
It says, for who is able to judge these by judges thy so great a people?
Who is able to judge these people? They are so great a people because they are your people. You are a great God and your people are great.
Amen.
How can I judge them? How can I rule over them? Go on.
And the speech pleased the Lord, and that Solomon had asked this thing.
Read that part again.
And the speech pleased the Lord.
He said, and the speech, this is Bible. And the speech, what?
Please the Lord.
That means that Solomon had spoken and the heavens heard him.
Yes.
So the key that his father had been transferred to him when he speaks to Solomon.
Amen.
Because ye have asked these things. In another scripture, he said, ask and it shall be given. If you have faith. Because ye have asked these things.
Right. Listen good.
Because ye have asked these things.
Mm-hmm.
What did he say?
And has not asked for thyself long life.
And have not asked for thyself. That means that God saw that this prayer, you see, has not asked for long life for thyself. So he did not ask for the things of the flesh. But Solomon was asking something that reached God spiritually. So he said that you didn't ask for physical things, but you asked for something that I'm deciding to be spiritual.
Mm.
What did he say there?
Neither had asked for riches for thyself, nor had
Lord,
asked for the life of thy enemies, but thou hast asked for thyself understanding to discern judgment.
Amen.
Behold, I have done according to thy words.
He said, Lord. Behold, I, God, have done according to you your way.
Amen.
Amen. And that is the permissive will of God. That is the key that is given in Acts, and it shall be given.
Amen.
But the reason why you ask is not given is there is no faith activating those words. So Solomon with the key asked, and God said, he said, you didn't ask for riches. Do you know that the Bible says that God said to Jeremiah that I know the thought that I have concerning you.
Amen.
And there are a thought, he said, that declares the Lord of hosts. And there are thoughts that will do what? Will bring you prosperity.
Right.
There are thoughts, they are not thoughts that will harm you. But there are thoughts that are good, that will give you a future.
That's right.
That is a thought God has concerning every human being.
Amen.
So he said, that is within my will. And you did not even pray that I should give you riches.
Mm.
You didn't pray that I should hand you over your enemies. Those that pray, Lord, kill my enemies. So that, when we come to one life, we are killing people more than we are giving life. Because they are fleshy things. That's what I want. If somebody is troubling me, I serve a living God. I will go on my knees and I will pray against you. But watch this. He said, you didn't even ask for that.
That's right.
Because in my perfect will, all that is provided.
Amen.
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 But he said, Solomon, you ask something that has touched me. Right. And look, mark those words very well. He said, I would do according to what?
Good, I have done according to thy words.
Now I'm going to do. He said, I've done. Because every time you pray and it strikes God in his will, he does it immediately.
Amen.
He said, I've done according to your word.
Amen.
And that means that the word of Solomon was not actually the perfect will of God. Do you know why? I've come to realize by the power of revelation that every time man decides to walk on the permissive will of God, the end thereof is death. There's a way that seemeth right in the sight of man, but the end thereof is death. Every time you walk in the permissive will of God, the end is death. Because it's your own will. And your will that you gave came out of the flesh. So he said, flesh will go back into the flesh. So that will end into the death. So one may ask that Solomon, in all his wisdom, in all his discernment, he could not discern that God headed for you to worship other gods. He could not discern that he was the one that had over 700 concubines. How much are you as a man to have wives and have 700 other concubines? And this was the one that was working in the permissive will. And in the end of Solomon's reign, the kingdom of Israel was parted forever. After Solomon, the other nations, other tribes rose against Judah. And Israel has never been the same up to date. He ruled in the permissive will of God, not the perfect will of God. A man that walked in the permissive will of God and died in the permissive will of God is a man like Samson. God, in his perfect will, rose Samson up in a time where the Israelites were being oppressed. But Samson decided to walk in some other way. So in the end, Judges 16, the verse 28, in the end, Samson had to pray for his death to come so that he would take a lot of the Philistines with him to accomplish his mission. That was not the will of God for his life. But in the end, he ended up in permissive will. And one thing I want you to understand today, if you walk in the permissive will of God, even though that is coming in his will, the end thereof is death. As Jesus prayed, do you have that? Don't worry.
Okay.
I've already told them what is there. As Jesus prayed, Father, not my will. That means that his will could be good. And Jesus knew that he had a key to heaven. So if he spoke it, the heavens will respond. But he said, Lord, I know, nevertheless. Nevertheless means that even though I know you can grant me, nevertheless. That means that I know that it's possible. But I've chosen another route. And that is to walk in your will. And I know that your will says that you have a plan for my life. And it's a plan to prosper me. It's a plan that is good. And it's a plan that will give me a future. Other verses say it will give you an expected ending. And that is for us to one day walk into heaven when our Creator comes to give account. And when he looks upon us, he will see nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
And as we accepted it, we will walk majestically. And we say, Father, as they sang, I am coming home. Be on your feet.
Be on your feet.
Be on your feet.
Take that song, brother.
Come on, worship, worship, worship. church sing together.
Thank you.
the Lord.
Spiritually, as we were worshiping, as I touched him the first time, I saw that there were seven people carrying a coffin. And in the coffin, the seven people that were carrying the coffin, there were two women. And the Holy Ghost is ministering to me that these women have made an accusation. That is why they're holding the coffin. The Spirit of the Lord is ministering to me that let's pray for him and pray. Because as I touch him, I saw the coffin move, but I didn't see it disappear.
Jesus.
Are you married? Spiritually, there's a woman that is standing by you right now, and that woman says that she has married you. Mm. In the spirit.
Prophecy.
And the woman is saying, now as soon as I move to you, he said that don't pray for her. She's my entitlement.
Jesus.
But the angel that is with me, I saw the angel strike her. Go and pray for her.
Amen.
Today, in the name of Jesus, because in the realms of the spirit, before you were born, something transpired. And you were born to as a price to satisfy something. Because a transaction happened between certain people, and before you were formed, even in your womb, they had mentioned your name that when you come, you are the one they are going to use to pacify that thing.
Lord.
But today, you are coming home.
Amen.
Stretch out your hand. Let's pray for him real quick. Come on, pray. Pray for him.
Fire, Mapasha, Tapahaya, Italia, Brandesaya, Balabaya, Italia, Balabaya, Italia, Balabaya, 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 Yeah, bye-bye. in the hanging coffin, release fire, in the hanging coffin, release fire, release fire, release fire, release fire. Let the fire, let the consuming 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 fire. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I tell you, Papa Jesus.
You will not die before your time.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. They thought they had finished.
And I hear God has separated one of the numbers. Amen. And I explained what the numbers were. 2 and 7 was for delivery. I hear that God is saying to me that there are many here who your month of delivery has come.
Amen.
Many here. Before we do the communion, man of God can put that. Before we do the communion.
Just to the glory of God.